Commission meeting. It's great to have a full room. We'll do a roll call.
Certainly. Mayor Brooke?
Here.
Vice Mayor Serra?
Present.
Commissioner Bowen?
Here.
Commissioner Simmons?
Here.
Commissioner Carter?
Present.
Thank you.
Everybody.
City Manager Babinick. Here. And City Attorney Hearn.
Here.
Thank you.
Great. If everybody would please rise and join us for a moment of silence, whoever might be in your hearts. Thank you so much. And please welcome up our three pledgers. We have Addison Cuccia from Country Hills Elementary, fourth grader. Addison, if you'd come up to the mic. Valeria Duran from Renaissance Charter School, fourth grader. Welcome. Good to have you. And last but not least, Myra Nguyen from Riverside Elementary, kindergarten. Hi. Okay, you ladies ready? Okay. I pledge
to the flag, to the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Fantastic, fantastic. We have some shorts for you.
Oh.
And the whole commission is going to come down to greet you. Everybody else can be seated. Thank you. This one.
This is your.
Yeah.
So I'll take it.
Okay. We have a few recognitions this evening, which is always great. Julie, we're recognizing National Community Planning Month. Come on down, Tina, Julie.
Enjoy, I'll let you read that.
Hey, Tina, how are you? Hello again. How are you? How are you? Wonderful. How's it going? Good to see you. Hi, how you doing?
Thank you for being here. Hi.
Good to see you too.
Thank you for being here.
Happy to recognize you. We're going to hand the mic over to you. So, as we're recognizing our planners, you know, our community is a master plan community. We need a couple more on this side. And these planners help keep things orderly, beautiful, and safe. So on behalf of the commission, we're just very happy to recognize you all and say thank you for your hard work. And Tina.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Commission. I want to just say that I'm so honored and thankful to be working with such an amazing team. Everyone that's standing up here and those that are not even standing up here, they work so hard every single day to make sure our business community, our residents, internally, externally, everyone in the city is well taken care of. And they really take pride in their work. So thank you to everybody here. We were looking over our accomplishments for the last year, and it was amazing. It was like over 6 pages of accomplishments. I'm not going to read all of them, but I just wanted to point out a few because it's amazing when you look back in the year and you think about all the things that you've done and what great of a job this team does. We processed and reviewed almost 5,500 permits, 2,400 zoning inspections, almost 5 land development code, land development code amendments, over 50 DRC projects, whether they're small developments or large developments. We're shooting to get LEED certified for cities. We have been able to execute an ILA for over $20 million in surtax money. So these are big things that you're seeing and actually able to see on the ground as you're going through the city. So it's just such an amazing thing. Thank you.
Awesome. Then you give it to Joy.
And of the things that Tina pointed out, that is value for your dollar.
Yes.
So the city has a special proclamation for National Community Planning Month. Community planning helps manage the constant change that affects cities by providing better choices for how people work and live. The American Planning Association and the American Institute of Certified Planners endorse this month as an opportunity to highlight the contributions, sound planning, and implementation made to the quality of our environment. Therefore, we, the City Commission of Coral Springs, proclaim October 2024 as National Community Planning Month in the City of Coral Springs, signed by the Coral Springs Commission. Thank you.
Thank you, Joy. And I'm going to put you here in a minute.
I want to make sure the certificate is sent to. That's right. Tina's got it.
No. All right, our next recognition is Proclamation for National Arts and Humanities Month, 2024. Juliana and your team. All right, congratulations.
Pamela, nice to see you.
Thank you.
So we are recognizing National Arts and Humanities Month 2024. October is National Arts and Humanities Month, a collective recognition of the importance of culture in America. National Arts and Humanities Month was launched by Americans for the Arts more than 30 years ago as National Arts Week in honor of the 20th anniversary of the National Endowment for the Arts and National Endowment for Humanities. In 1993, it was reestablished by Americans for the Arts and National Arts Partners as a month-long celebration with goals of focusing on equitable access to the arts at local, state, and national levels, encouraging individuals, organizations, and diverse communities to participate in the arts, allowing government and businesses to show their support of the arts, and raising public awareness about the positive impact of the arts and humanities in our communities and lives. I'm gonna pass the mic over to my colleague to read the proclamation.
All right. This is a special proclamation for National Arts and Humanities Month.
National Arts and Humanities Month is an opportunity for everyone to help change public perception and promote the crucial role of the arts and humanities in promoting individual well-being, addressing trauma, connecting cultures, and making our community healthier and stronger. Therefore, we, the City Commission of Coral Springs, proclaim October 2024 as National Arts and Humanities Month in the City of Coral Springs.
As for you, would you like to say a few words?
Hi, everyone. My name is Pamela Salatis. I am the Education and Public Programs Coordinator at the Coral Springs Museum of Art. Regrettably, our Arts and Culture Program Manager, Juliana Ferrero, could not make it tonight, but we'd like to say a few words of thank you. As we formally recognize and celebrate National Arts and Humanities Month, we at the Coral Springs Museum of Art would like to extend our gratitude to the City of Coral Springs for acknowledging the vital role that art plays in our lives. Your proclamation today underscores the importance of creativity and cultural expression in our community. Recognition of the significance of the arts is a meaningful contribution that helps us continue to offer rich and diverse exhibitions, classes, events, and other programs to this amazing city and beyond. Your presence and support mean a great deal to the museum. Just so you're aware, this is the final week to view our current exhibitions, which explore thought-provoking themes like memory, dementia, Alzheimer's, identity, and construction. I encourage everyone to attend and witness firsthand how art changes lives. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. We're going to put you in the middle, and I'm going to be a bookend. George Soberon, come on down with your team. We have a special proclamation for National Code Compliance Month. Hey, George, how are you?
Good.
Congratulations. It's your month. You're back again? How are you?
Good. My ride-along buddy. How are you?
Oh, ride-along. All right. So I'm going to share a few words, hand the mic over to George, and then have Nancy read the proclamation. So our division provides for the safety, health, and welfare of all of our citizens through the enforcement of codes and ordinances, which also helps to preserve and enhance the aesthetic citywide. They often are underappreciated. We happen to value them quite a bit here in Coral Springs on the commission, and they're underappreciated because when they're approaching somebody, it's not with the approach to make you wrong. It's with the approach to get things right, and it's not with the approach to fine you. It's with the approach to, you know, be part of our community and follow the codes that we've put together over the years for our safety, for our well-being, and for the aesthetic appeal of this beautiful city. So I just want to say thank you on behalf of the commission for all the work you do day in and day out, and say thank you on behalf of some of those citizens that don't necessarily recognize the value, right? So you need to hear that too. So George.
Thank you, Mayor, Commissioners. On behalf of the code team and development services, thank you for your support. Look, it's really about this team and the folks that couldn't make it tonight, our inspectors, our office staff. You know, there's so many moving parts to just seeing something, you know, a tree that needs to be trimmed or a hedge that needs to be installed. There's steps we have to go through. We try to help the residents, give them plenty of time to fix it. But in the end, we want the city to look good and set the standard. And that's what we do. As we go forward in the next year, we have our aesthetics initiative, which has always been our initiative. So we'll keep working at that. And if anybody needs anything, reach out to us. We're trying to make the city look better. I drive the city, lived in the city for 30 years. I was some of the folks out there say, why isn't somebody doing something about that? So we see it too, and we're doing it. So again, appreciate it. Thank you for support. Thank you for the other departments who are working with us, and we'll do that more in the future. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you, George. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So this is a special proclamation, National Code Compliance Month, in recognition of your efforts to provide a safe, healthy, aesthetically beautiful place to live and work for the citizens in this community. We commend you for the hard work and dedication you perform every day through the enforcement of important city codes and ordinances. Therefore, we, the City Commission of Coral Springs, proclaim October 2024 as National Code Compliance Month in the City of Coral Springs, signed by the Commission.
All right.
All right, our next proclamation. We got some firefighters here. Fire Prevention Week 2024 with Deputy Chief Mosier leading the way. How are you? How are you? Welcome. Thanks for your work. How are you? Good to see you. How's it going?
Good to see you.
How are you? Good to see you. How are you? Welcome.
We're going to have some going outside. We're going to have some going outside.
All right. Deputy Chief, you want to take it away?
So thank you to our staff for joining us. We're actually going to be here for two proclamations, so you guys are going to hang out. The first is our Fire Prevention Week, and covering for our Fire Marshal is Captain Matos. He's going to give you just a brief rundown.
Thank you, everybody, for attending. For our Fire Prevention Week, the theme is smoke detectors, smoke alarms, make them work for you. 3 out of 5 home fire deaths happens in homes where they did not have smoke alarms or they failed to operate. So please make sure you check your smoke alarms once a month. And for the month of October, we have a couple of events. This Saturday, October 5th, we have a fire prevention safety day at the Home Depot at 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. October 12th, we have our fire safety jamboree at the Coral Square Mall from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We will have a live burn demonstration. And October 19th, we have our pasta dinner. That's it. Thank you.
And we'll give you more on the pasta dinner in the next one.
So twice a year, there's something that occurs in your world that affects you. And this is the perfect time for you to remember to change those batteries in your smoke alarm. And that next date is November 3rd. Change your batteries during daylight savings. It's simple to remember twice a year. So the city has a special proclamation for Fire Prevention Week. The City of Coral Springs is committed to ensuring the safety and security of all those living and visiting our city. As we proclaim Fire Prevention Week, we encourage residents to take personal steps to increase fire safety in the community by adhering to this year's theme, smoke alarms, make them work for you. Therefore, we, the City Commission of Coral Springs, proclaim the week of October 6th through 12th, 2024, as Fire Prevention Week in the City of Coral Springs, signed by the Coral Springs Commission. Thank you for what you do.
We'll put you in the middle. Got some broken glasses over there? Looks like you're staying up here. So our next recognition is to recognize the month of October as Cancer Awareness Month. So I'm going to read the proclamation, then hand the mic over. In recognition of your work to promote cancer awareness throughout the month of October and for raising meaningful funds that support cancer research, prevention, treatment, and survivorship, we thank you for your efforts. We are proud to support your department and the community to educate firefighters and the public about the importance of cancer awareness. Therefore, we, the City Commission of Coral Springs, proclaim October 2024 as Cancer Awareness Month in the city of Coral Springs. Thank you for the work that you do, and thank you for promoting it, Mike.
Lieutenant Farmer.
Good evening, everyone. Mike Farmer, I'm the president of the Coral Springs Firefighters Benevolent Association. We have a little event coming up. You may have been there before, October 19th, our annual pasta dinner. This started, we've been doing it now 12 years. So started with a pot of sauce. Chief Babinick, wonderful idea. We've grown every year. It's a great community event. We hope to see everybody out there. Bring their kids, bring the adults, bring the grandparents, bring everyone. It's a great way to spend a day with the firefighters, touring the fire station, checking out all the apparatus, getting to talk one-on-one with the residents, the volunteers, everybody else in the community. Enjoy a great homemade meal. It's an $8 donation. It goes back to the Coral Springs Firefighters Benevolent Association, and we give that money back to the University of Miami Firefighters Cancer Initiative, which helps with families and firefighters directly locally for cancer awareness, cancer prevention, and cancer treatments. So it's very important, you know, that we do this. We continue it every year. We continue to grow every year. The pink shirts are just one of the things that we do, which started about 15 years ago. We continue to do so. If you like the pink shirts, we have them available for sale the night of the dinner. So come on out, make a donation. You can go on our website, coralspringsfirefighters.org, check out our Facebook page, look for some wonderful city Facebooks coming out, some TikTok videos that became very popular a couple years ago. We've got new ones coming out this year as well.
The star?
The star is, I don't, somebody in a pink shirt. So look forward to that. There's a QR code on there. You know, spread the word to family and friends as well. If you can't make it out to the dinner, you can still go on there and make a tax-deductible donation through the QR code, and just come out and have a great time. Also that night is the event over at the gymnasium for the children, the trick-or-treating. That ends at 5 p.m. Our dinner's from 5 to 9. It's a great opportunity to come on over, have some dinner, and the kids can trick-or-treat there as well. So we hope to see you out there. We thank you for your continued support of the city, and we look forward to another great year. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. So I'm here today to recognize a very special educator in the room with us tonight. She previously served as an assistant principal in Coral Springs Maplewood Elementary School. She left for a brief stint to serve as an AP at Dillard Elementary in Fort Lauderdale. She is a true believer in education. She earned her bachelor's degree from University of Miami, master's degree from NSU, specialist degree from Florida Atlantic, and she... currently is pursuing her doctoral degree from FAU as well. So she is a true believer in education, the power of education. Her goal for her school is to create a place where every student, whether they're gifted, high achieving, special needs, that they succeed. So we're very happy she's returned home to Coral Springs. Put your hands together and welcome for me the new principal of the A-rated Maplewood Elementary School, Ms. Camille Orr.
Welcome home.
All right. This is a special recognition for Camille Orr, Principal Camille Orr. The City of Coral Springs appreciates and supports your unwavering commitment and exceptional leadership to the students and families of Maplewood Elementary School. Our heartfelt welcome and a safe school year. Thank you for being here. Signed by the Commission.
All right. Awesome. Yeah, you can share some words.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for this recognition. I am elated to be back in the city of Coral Springs. Like April said, I was here 5 years ago as the assistant principal at Maplewood, and we are an A-rated school. And I just want to give a shout out to some amazing educators that are here supporting me from Maplewood this evening. So, guys, if you can stand up for a second and say hi. They are a little shy, but we do look forward to partnering with the city to make sure that we provide our scholars with a world-class education. And we have one of our former OWLs. She was a student at Maplewood when I was there. She was a fifth grader back then, and she's actually come back to volunteer at our school, and she will soon be employed there. All right. So we are so proud of her.
So my older three children actually went there many, many years ago.
Oh, wow.
Yes,
oh,
absolutely. I think Miss Orange might have been the principal, but I'm not sure.
Yes, and actually her daughter-in-law is my math coach.
Oh, how about that? Yes, how about that?
Miss Orange is daughter-in-law there. Yes.
Well, we're very happy to have you back.
Oh, thank you.
All right, agenda item number 7. We've got John Norris here, and we are recognizing William Ray and Justin Ellis.
So I want to invite Billy Ray up. Billy Ray is retiring after 43 years. He has only spent 1 year in public works. However, this item is listed under public works. So that's why I invited Justin Ellis. He worked for 42 years in the Parks Department, 1 year in public works, and he goes to retire. I don't know what calls that. But I'm going to hand over the mic to Justin Ellis, and if you don't mind giving...
I have something prepared I'd like to share. I put some notes in my phone so I didn't forget what I wanted to say. So today we gather here to celebrate a remarkable individual and his incredible career. Billy Ray has dedicated over 4 decades of his life serving the city of Coral Springs, and his contributions have been nothing short of extraordinary. Billy's unwavering commitment to our community and his passion for making Coral Springs a better place to work, live, and raise a family have been evident throughout his tenure in the Parks and Recreation Department. His efforts have helped create and maintain beautiful parks and spaces we enjoy today, and ensuring that future generations can experience the same joy and sense of community. Beyond his hard work, Billy has been an exceptional colleague, a true leader, and someone who is always willing to go the extra mile and support his team. His positive attitude, generosity, and wealth of experience have left a lasting impact on all of us. Billy, you've been more than an employee. You've been a role model and inspiration. On behalf of the city of Coral Springs, thank you for over 4 decades of dedicated service, which we wish you the very best in this next chapter of your life. You will always be a valued member of our community.
So I'm going to read the special recognition and then let Billy share a few of his words. Come on next to me, Billy. Don't be scared. Although it is Tuesday. I do bite on Tuesdays, and I won't bite you. So the City of Coral Springs is very proud of your successful career as a vital part of both the Parks and Rec and the Public Works Departments.
Thank you.
In roles, you focused on our parks, our fields, our facilities, our landscapes, and of course, all the families we have here in our community. We thank you for more than 40 years of dedicated service and contributions to the city as you help to ensure premier amenities that were enjoyed by residents and all the children. We, the City Commission of Coral Springs, congratulate you and wish you a long and healthy retirement.
Well, thank you.
You're very welcome. My pleasure, Billy. That's for you. Would you like to share a few words?
I would.
Great. Yes.
Perfect. Thank you, John and Justin, Mayor. Thank you, Commissioners. Our City Manager, Frank, and his staff, thank you. In the City of Coral Springs, I've been thankful for the many opportunities I have serving the City of Coral Springs for 43 years. I would like to share a memory with you, my first day in the job in 1981. My boss, Al Crisanti, at the time introduced me to the pine stick backhoe. He said, Bill, this is going to be your best friend. For those of you who do not know what a pine stick backhoe is, it's a shovel. And yes, he was right. It turned out to be my best friend. Thanks to my supervisors in Parks and Recreation, and recently Claudia Zalte in Public Works, and my fellow workers for all their help and support. I can't forget my irrigation crew, Dan, Nick, Fernando, and James for their support, hard work, dedication, and customer service. A special thank you to my wife, Darlene, for all her love and support. Today, my wife celebrates 9 years as a breast and bladder cancer survivor. Woo! I will always cherish the memories and the friendships that I have made here. It was my pleasure to be able to serve the City of Coral Springs, and thank you all.
You did great.
Thank you. And the mic over.
You did great. And so we have a gift or two.
Yes.
Would you like to present it?
Absolutely.
Wow.
Oh, my God. All right. So we have this token of appreciation. William Billy Ray, 1981 to 2024. Congratulations on your retirement, and it's kind of a,
I think
what
it
do
lights
you call
up.
That? Can't think of the name, but that's City Hall.
Hologram.
Hologram.
Thank you.
Good City job. Hall.
Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, my God. Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right. We'll get a picture.
This is a special proclamation for me. We will be recognizing Indigenous Peoples Day, so if we can have our representatives from Big Cypress and the Immokalee Board come on up. Yeah, of course. So pretty. Come on in the middle. Don't they look so beautiful?
Yes.
On Indigenous Peoples Day, we honor the perseverance and the courage of Indigenous people, show our gratitude for the contributions they have made to our world, and to renew our commitment to respect tribal sovereignty and self-determination. This day is celebrated across the United States on the second Monday in October and is an official city and state holiday in various localities. The story of America's Indigenous people is a story of the resilience and survival, of their persistent commitment to the right of self-governance, and of their determination to preserve cultures, identities, and ways of life. Long before European explorers sailed to this continent, Native American and Alaska Native nations made this land their home.
some for thousands of years before the United States was founded. They built many nations that created powerful, prosperous, and diverse cultures, and they developed knowledge and practices that still benefit us. Today, indigenous people are beacons of resilience, strength, and perseverance, as well as a source of incredible contributions. Their diverse cultures and communities are a testament to the unshakable and unbreakable commitment of many generations to preserve their cultures, identities, and their right to self-governance. Thank you so much for being here. My colleague will read the proclamation. We'll pass the mic over to you.
All right, this is a special proclamation, Indigenous Peoples Day. The City of Coral Springs acknowledges the importance of Indigenous Peoples Day and recognizes the historical and ongoing contributions of Native peoples to the United States. We honor and celebrate the rich cultures, traditions, and resilience of Native American and Indigenous communities. Therefore, we, the City Commission of Coral Springs, proclaim October 14th, 2024, as Indigenous Peoples Day in the City of Coral Springs. And if anybody got a problem with that, you can come see me. Signed by the City Commission of Coral Springs.
Shanabish. Thank you, Commissioner, Mayor. Thank you for this important proclamation recognizing Indigenous Peoples Day. This acknowledgement is a significant step towards honoring the rich history, culture, and contribution of the Indigenous community. It is also a call to action for all of us to learn more, engage with, and support Indigenous voices and rights. I am committed to fostering understanding and respect for the diverse cultures that makes up our community. Shanabish. Thank you.
Definitely is one of my favorite parts of the meeting to give acknowledgement and thanks to so many wonderful people in our community. We are now up to public comment. Signed public speakers.
Certainly. Our first signed speaker is Zelvin Maltsky.
Zeldin, are you here? All right, we'll go to the next one.
Sandra Tan.
I know Sandra, I don't see her. Okay, we'll go to the next one.
Kurt Tiefenburn.
Hi, good evening.
Hi, good evening.
My name is Kurt Tiefenburn. I reside in 9228 Northwest 2nd Street. Here representing myself, of course, but also representing CSID, Coral Springs Improvement District. We supply drinking water, wastewater processing, and flood control to the southern third of Coral Springs in the 33071 zip code. And the reason I'm here is I have what I think is a pretty good idea, and I chose to share it publicly in this forum because it also gives me an opportunity to share similar accomplishments of our staff at CSID. Last meeting we had here during the property tax budget hearing, I felt it would be beneficial to highlight specific cost-saving measures conceived purely by staff going above and beyond to save our residents money on specific projects around our city. For For example, we at CSID had initially budgeted a $295,000 budget to have a contractor install 40 water sampling stations throughout the district for collecting monthly samples that we send off to the Florida Department of Environmental Protection. Through the thoughtful attention of our water plant manager, Christian McShay, he and other staff devised a plan to install these sampling stations throughout our district at a more convenient location, which would be our lift stations. So there would be a lot less labor and plumbing involved, and we wouldn't need the contractor. So we'd have a, now we only have a materials cost, which we saved about $185,000 just on that one little plan there. So I originally planned to share several others, but I think you get the point. Whether it's $25,000 or $60,000, there are employees at CSID that are always eager to find cost savings for our residents. So I thought it would be a good practice for our city, and we're going to feature this in our next newsletter, would be to feature a member or members of city staff receiving an award for a specific cost-saving measure that, if it not for that employee and their thoughtful ingenuity, the cost savings would never have occurred. This award event could be featured in the Coral Springs Magazine, on Coral Springs TV, or right here in one of our commission meetings. Each time you have this opportunity to make this example, you also have an opportunity to share with our residents that this is a common theme among Coral Springs staff, as it is with ours at CSID, that we never spend our residents' money with careless disregard. And if you do this intermittently throughout the year, perhaps many more residents would be a bit more understanding during the property tax rollout that we have each late summer. So thanks.
Thank you. So as we're about to call up other members from the public, this is a reminder that normally when you come up, we may or may not respond to you so that we're not engaged in debate per se. And it's possible that any one of us might share comments later on under City Commissioner comments. Do we have any other signed speakers?
You have no other signed speakers.
Okay, would anybody from the public like to be heard? Good evening.
Good evening, everyone. Joe Morera, 3275 Northwest 114th Lake. I just became aware of the news that everyone learned today publicly. Our city manager has decided to leave our city and enjoy some greener pasture and a much better world. So he looks forward to his retirement. I just want to say, Frank, thank you for all you've done. I know you came on board here when things were not so smooth. You took over the rudder of this ship, and you basically steered in the right direction, and you have kept us going in the right path and help our community continue to be the best what it is. So thank you for all your time. Thank you for all your work that you did as your fire chief. And we're certainly going to not have find a replacement because I think you're one of a kind. But nonetheless, thank you for all you do to contribute to the city well-being. And we hope you have a wonderful, relaxing, and much better, comfortable life than you have today. Thank you for all you do.
You're welcome. Thanks, Joe. Would somebody else like to be heard? Good evening.
Good evening. Keith Roberts, 8950 Northwest 45th Court, Coral Springs, Florida. I am here today to discuss some of the agenda items, particularly into the bids that are being awarded or recommended for award. Maybe about 2 years ago, I met with Ms. Bartlett and maybe your economic department in regards to having bids awarded to Coral Springs small businesses. There's a lot of Coral Springs small businesses in the city, and I see, as an example, there are some that are getting awarded out of state and even out of the city. You have several contractors and several vendors that are here locally, and why don't the city consider hiring or giving the award to those specific vendors? I mentioned that perhaps you may want to look into a local business enterprise, which means that when you put the bids out, local vendors will get some type of preference, whether if it's an RFP, request for proposal, or RFQ, request for qualification. Maybe they could get some additional points to help them get up that point scale or the system to get awarded the contract. Lastly, the last one was here, we spoke about mental illness, and I'm glad to see that as of today, there was a bill that came into place to move homeless people off the streets and find a safe shelter for them. So I applaud the governor for that. However, as I looked around the city today, we have one person in particular, and I know this because he's been on my corner where we live at, single-handedly driving our values of our properties down. Because when somebody comes to look at your property and you see a guy out there with a tent, five umbrellas, a shopping cart, a bicycle, you know, I'm all for helping. And I've given this guy money, and several other people, they just stop by and they just give him stuff. Sometimes they're upset. He's upset, he'll throw the food back at him. I don't need your money, the whole nine yards. So I saw him out here today. I questioned your 911, non-emergency, and asked why is he still there? And I couldn't get an answer. So I applaud the governor for doing what's right. And again, I'm all for helping homeless and people with mental illness. Thank you.
Thank you. Would anybody else from the public like to be heard? All right, seeing none, public comment is closed. We're on to consent. Any polls? Would you like to move it?
Move to approve.
Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All right, carries unanimously. We're on to policy formation and direction. 17, roofing supplies and services, waterproofing and related products and services.
Good evening, Commission. Requesting to renew the contract for roofing supply and services with Garland DBS Incorporated. This is a piggyback contract with Racine County, Wisconsin, with an annual expenditure not to exceed $1.75 million. This is to replace and repair roofs throughout the city. We have many, many large buildings, and we try to keep the roofs up to date and in good serviceable condition. Happy to answer any questions.
Any questions? All right. Is there a motion?
Move to approve.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed, say nay. All right. Moves unanimously.
Thank you.
Thank you, John. Next is Resolution 2024-042, Allocation for School Resource Officer at Coral Springs Charter School.
Mayor, this is an allocation for the school resource officer we have over at the charter school. There was an item at an earlier meeting today with the board for the school on this item, and just ratifying that.
Okay. Any questions for Catherine? All right. Somebody like to move it?
Move to approve.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
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 All right, carries unanimously. Thank you. And next is item number 19, professional consulting services, the request to waive the competitive procurement process consistent with section 2-305.1.7.
Mayor, this is the item I asked to be pulled.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yes, sir.
I looked at the old agenda.
No problem.
All right, this item is pulled. Please excuse me, Frank. Next item is number 20, installation of citywide fiber optic network infrastructure. Hey there, Stephen, how are you?
I'm doing great, thank you.
Good.
So currently the city has 32 locations that we have data connectivity to. Those are all connected via leased circuits from AT&T and Bluestream. This project is to install our own fiber completely underground. Most of our leased fiber is aerial, so this will protect us from hurricanes. It'll also allow us to provide higher speeds at most of the parks that we provide free Wi-Fi to.
Okay, any questions for Stephen?
Comment.
So I have a question. So about how long did this process take?
From the time we start construction, They're telling us about 18 months.
Gotcha, okay. All right, go ahead, Joy.
As I mentioned earlier, there are things that are done in the city that people do not see There are behind the scenes things, underground things, and these are the things that provide value to you as a resident. And I just wanted to highlight that. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Great. Would somebody like to move it?
Move to approve.
Second.
All right, motion and a second. It's a request to award and authorize. Any discussion?
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
I just want to make sure I point out that one of the funding sources for this fiber optic network is from the American Rescue Plan Act, and we have a number of those projects that we have funded throughout the last couple of years from the current Biden-Harris administration, and I just want to point that out. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
You bet. Any further discussion? All right, all in favor, please say aye.
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 All right, carries unanimously. Thank you, Stephen. And last before Commissioner Communications is the appointment of Dennis Bovell to the Financial Advisory Committee. It's a request to appoint. Is there a motion to approve?
Move to approve.
Any discussion? You can always use a good mind on the Financial Advisory Committee. Any further discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
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 All right, carries unanimously. So I am going to call on Commissioner Carter to go first with Commission Communications.
The least prepared, but thank you.
Well, then I'm going to go to Commissioner Nancy Mateo-Bowen first.
Right.
Because I'm sure she has at least 11 pages of notes that she cut down to four.
Yes, I'll be quick.
Right?
Yes, I'll be quick this evening. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. For those, just really want to send out my deepest sympathies to those impacted by Hurricane Helene. And I understand as we continue to see the destruction caused by this hurricane, want to say an incredible heartfelt thank you to our brave firefighters from Coral Springs who have deployed to assist the recovery efforts, including our city manager. Thank you so much for all that you do for our community here in Coral Springs, but also the state of Florida. I also want to take this opportunity to inform that our residents that Coastal Waste and Recycling is now responsible for our collections of solid waste, recyclables, yard waste, and bulk trash in our community effective today. For important information about pickup schedule, cart distribution, etc., please check out our website at coralsprings.gov. Friendly reminder, voter registration, the deadline is October 7th. Please, 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 if you have not checked your voter registration, please do that so before October 7th so you are able to vote this upcoming general election. To do so, you can go to browardvotes.gov to do, they have all that information listed for you. To my Jewish brothers and sisters, happy Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish New Year from October 2nd to the 4th. I want to extend my warmest wishes to all celebrating in our Coral Springs community and beyond. May this time be a reflection and renewal bring you and your loved ones peace, joy, and prosperity. Lashana Tova. May you have a sweet and prosperous New Year. Excuse me. If you have any concerns, if any concerns or wish to meet with me, I have office hours every second and fourth Thursday of the month. Please make an appointment with Luam. She's amazing. At 954-344-5911. If you would like to reach me directly, please send me a text message at 954-254-8880. And finally, I would like to extend my best wishes to our city manager, Frank Babinick. I know you don't like the attention. But you deserve all of the great things coming your way in this next chapter. You've dedicated 30 years to our city, from our fire department to leading our city to where it is today. You have been an important part of our community, and we wish you all the best in this next chapter. I know this is not your last meeting, but as the recent news you shared that you'll be moving on, very bittersweet. And again, thank you for all that you do for our community. And that concludes my comments, Ms. Mayor.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. All right, back over to you, Joy.
Mr. Mayor, also to my friends who celebrate a happy Rosh Hashanah this week and this coming Saturday. I'll look forward to seeing you at our Oktoberfest celebration. please have something other than beer. The one thing I don't drink.
I heard there's going to be wine.
Thank you.
That's wine, W-I-N-E.
Yes, I do that too. If you need to reach me, my phone contact is 954-998-4186. My email is joycarter@coralsprings.gov and any of the social media channels at CS Commissioner 5. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
All right. Thank you very much. Commissioner Simmons.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Earlier during our commission meeting, during our recognition and proclamation section, the City Commission with the Coral Springs Fire Department proclaimed October 6th through the 12th as Fire Prevention Week in the City of Coral Springs, with this year's theme being Smoke Alarms, Make Them Work for You. Also with the Coral Springs Fire Department, we recognize the month of October 2024 as Cancer Awareness Month, and firefighters are going to be wearing their navy blue or pink t-shirts with a lavender ribbon representing all types of cancer. They also, the fire department also invited the community to the annual Cancer Awareness Pasta Dinner on Saturday, October 19th at Fire Station 80 from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. There is an $8 donation which goes supports efforts to fight cancer and bring more cancer awareness. Second to the gentleman that spoke during public comment about a local preference in our procurement code, that is something that I know personally I worked on, and the commission, we all got a local procurement code into action. Unfortunately, sometimes local businesses aren't able to either fulfill the requirements of what we're looking for, or they just come back a little too expensive. But for the most part, we've done a great job of looking inward before we go outward. And there are other guidelines around procurement and contracts and things like that, but we do have a local preference in our procurement code. We are all witnessing the effects of Hurricane Helene, and my heart goes out to all those impacted in the Panhandle and in Northwest Florida and throughout the rest of the United States that have been impacted by this storm. But here in Florida, unfortunately, we're seeing what we've been kind of ringing the alarms about for a few months now about our insurance crisis. And unfortunately, our governor has decided to spend his time and taxpayer dollars on fighting citizen-led ballot initiatives instead of spending time fixing something that will help all Floridians, especially in this critical time of climate change, especially during hurricane season. And so now we are going to see a lot of folks struggling to get reimbursed or get their being made whole from this storm. You know, you pay your insurance every month, but then when it's time to go and get money from your insurance companies, folks are now having to sue in order to get what they deserve to get from being on-time payers to their insurance policies. And this is something that has been happening for years, but unfortunately, our government in Florida has not been focused on fixing that issue. And so I hope that the folks that had insurance, hopefully they weren't dropped. Hopefully they, are able to get something going, because what's happened since the last hurricane, there are folks that are actually suing to be made whole and get their viable items together. And so for the folks in Coral Springs, oftentimes when we have issues and we say that's not, we can't do anything about it, that's a state issue, it's not because we're trying to pass the buck. We want to make sure your voices are being heard in the halls and in the places where it needs to be heard, so that those who can make a difference and help are hearing that. And that goes, a lot of our issues with what's happening goes to the state government in Tallahassee. And so, again, it's not us passing the buck. It's just making sure that you come with us when we are raising our voices, because we always do. This commission is really good about defending Coral Springs when it comes to the overreach of Tallahassee. But we also want to make sure our residents come with us so that they can see us in a united front and hear all of our voices. And with that, I'm complete. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
All right. Thank you. So thank you for your well wishes for the new year. I am looking forward to the head of the year. That's exactly what Rosh Hashanah stands for. And I'll actually be in Temple in Atlanta, because I'm going there tomorrow for a few days. And I want to wish all of my fellow brethren that celebrate good Rosh Hashanah. If you need to reach me, best way to do so is email sbrook@coralsprings.gov. That way we can preserve your concerns, ideas, or desire to meet. And we have office hours anytime from 2 to 3, 4 times a month in October. I'll have 2 sets of office hours. And if you need to make an appointment, call the WOM at 954-344-5911. You know, Sean happens to be away to celebrate his wife's book tour, which I think is so wonderful. And then I just decided, well, let me look up when is National Book Month. Guess what? It's October. So although Sean's not here at the moment, I would love for us unanimously to recognize National Book Month next October, so 1 year heads up, and recognize our local authors, including Sean's wife. So,
Mayor, if you want, we could. If you want to take action now, we can do a draft and adopt for a resolution.
For the next meeting?
Well, recognizing it this month.
Great.
And you're not going to present it to anybody. We can present it when it comes back and then put it on for next year.
That'd be great.
But John, is that good?
Wonderful.
Frank's retiring from the city manager. He's going to become the city attorney, see?
I love it.
He's taught me well.
You know, we actually have several local authors that have published multiple books. But Sean's wife has done so in an incredible way. And actually, we have another author here in Joshua. So I'm very proud of our local authors, including Sean's wife, including Joshua. And I'd love to be able to recognize them. So thank you for that. You know, we're at a time, we're a month away from the election. We are, you know, 6 days away from October 7th and having to relive some of those horrible memories. And I just would urge everybody, you know, in this time of often high tensions, to pause, take time to reflect. You know, really consider what your objective is, what your desire is, and then be strategic, you know, about the response that you choose. You know, I can tell you recently, I was charged in a family law court. I actually had my opponent put up his 2 middle fingers during a hearing, and it's on Zoom, so the judge can easily see it. So I remarked that that was completely inappropriate. I did pause. I breathed. And I asked the judge, kindly, would you please admonish the other attorney for raising his 2 middle fingers to me? She said, oh, I didn't know he did that. Guess what? He did it again. He showed his 2 middle fingers again. So I say that not to shame this individual whose name, you know, I won't share with you. I share that with you because, you know, I do family law for a living. It's tough. It is not easy to do. I mean, I'm dealing with people that are really often at their worst. And sometimes attorneys like this person, they take on the emotions of the case and maybe even the negative emotions of the moment. And I can tell you, I'm not mistake-free. Last time I was before this one particular judge in Delray Beach, I apologized to her for my behavior the last hearing before that because I was so upset. And I did not pause before I reacted that day. So I'm giving this gentleman a little bit of grace, and the judge did admonish him. He later apologized, and he's apologized again since. But I would just urge you, you know, we all need each other. We really all need each other. It's one of the main reasons I love living here in Coral Springs, let alone being the mayor. And just take that time to pause, because chances are you're going to come up with a much better decision, much better reaction than going right on the spot and interjecting, you know, what may be your true emotions at the moment, but you're more focused on the complaint or the problem than the solution. And I think it's so much more helpful to be focused on the solution. So thank you for listening to that. Lastly, this Saturday, we will be at Oktoberfest. It is a great community gathering. It is a great community celebration. There's actually going to be dancing. Luam asked me if I was going to commit to the dance afterwards. I told you no, but then Joy said she was going to do it. So I'm aiming for yes. And that's another thing, just really about all 4 of us that I work with up here, Joshua, Joy, Nancy, and Sean. One of the reasons I love working with you all so much is your energy and your passion for the community. And it's wonderful. And with that, I'm complete. Over to you, Frank.
Thank you, Mayor.
I'm going to save my comments about you for another day.
Yes, sir. No. Yep. No.
Yes.
Yeah. Easy there, Joe. Easy. I do want to touch on the hurricane and the impacts it had throughout our country, throughout the Southeast. I got to, you know, see some of that firsthand, and really, what made me proud was the response that I got to see. The city of Coral Springs has always been an amazing neighbor. When our employees are called to help, this commission supports them going to help. This administration, our senior staff, supports them going to help because we needed that help at one time, and we will need that help again in the future. So it's important that we are there to help our sister communities throughout our state and beyond. I'm very proud of the men and women that deployed and the work that they did and will continue to do, because it is making a tremendous difference. Our teams are returning. We have most of them back safe. We still have a couple more that are out there that are finishing up their missions. So I just want to tell them thank you for their sacrifices, being away from their family and their friends to serve communities that, you know, they just don't know, but they're willing to go serve. Tonight was a great night for employee recognition. Speaking about our employees, you know, I applaud the efforts. I say it all the time. We have some of the most amazing public servants in existence, and, you know, I'm fortunate enough to see that work every day. And all of those that were recognized tonight deserve that recognition. And thank you to senior staff for leading such a great team. As mentioned before, I did announce I'm going to be retiring at the beginning of next year. There'll be more to come. I think I'm going to give like a piece of my speech every commission meeting from this point out, so that way I can just get through it. No, but in all honesty, you know, it wasn't an easy decision. There's more to come on that, and we'll certainly have more conversation in the near future. So that's it, Mayor. Thank you.
Sounds good, Frank. Thank you so much. JJ.
Thank you, Mayor. I'll reserve my comments and my roast for Frank later. But Frank knows very happy for him and excited for his future.
We will schedule a roast.
Absolutely. Sure. One update.
I know my time is up, Mr. Mayor, but Lynn has already said she wants to MC that, and I've already vetoed that.
Oh, I see Lynn clapping away. Absolutely. And Dale is already starting the jokes. He's putting those down.
I've an update on the House Bill 1365, which is the prohibition of public camping. We've been working with the county. There's a county draft ordinance, right? There's several components to it, right? The big push is that no one can regularly camp on public property. And the counties, working with the cities, have to go ahead and regulate that, but also provide a place. So the county's working on that. There's a draft ordinance that we've all put input. They've been very good about meeting with the city attorneys. They are going to their first public hearing on that October 8th. The ordinance, as provided for, is directed to giving those individuals a chance to move on, one, but also a chance to go to a facility where they can be helped if they would like as well. And that the very last option would be to do a citation or even, you know, criminal violation. So that's where it's at. We'll wait to hear first reading from the county to see what they do, and we'll continue to provide input. But by the House bill, by the current law, it's the county that must take the lead on that. That's their obligation.
Gotcha.
So that's your update, and I'll update you again next meeting, because they'll have their first public hearing.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you. So I just forgot to mention, next month I am going to do wine with the mayor for the first time in years. It's going to be at Total Wines in Loama. I'll let you know the date. We just need to work that out. And again, that'll be wine without the H, just W-I-N-A. And with that, we're complete. Everybody have a good evening. Again, if you celebrate Rosh Hashanah, Happy New Year. Thank you.